From the backyard brain's laboratory comes a new experiment, the effect of temperature on neurons. Here I have my standard cockroach-like prep and a digital thermometer showing the temperature in Fahrenheit. Notice, at room temperature, the cockroach light responds rather nicely to the manipulation by the Q-tip. Brr, cold, outdoor Michigan. 10 degrees and windy. Let's go do our experiment in the garage, where it's 20 degrees and no wind. Now I'm bringing the cockroach leg preparation from inside the house now into the garage. And as the temperature drops to around 20 degrees, the neurons in the cockroach leg will become inactive and will lose their ability to fire action potentials. This is due to the ion channels themselves being affected by the temperature. As the temperature drops below a threshold, the ion channels can no longer open and action potentials can no longer occur. Let's watch the oscilloscope iPhone I have as I manipulate the leg with the Q-tip. As the temperature drops to around 20 degrees, you will notice the amplitude of the activity is decreasing and decreasing until it is now almost completely gone. But are they gone permanently? Now I am returning the very cold cockroach leg back into the house to warm up. And though it almost instantaneously warms back up to room temperature, there's no neural activity present. Why is this? Perhaps the leg is dead. But we are patient scientists, and we will wait. I will manipulate the leg with my Q-tip and observe the neural activity on my iPhone. I'll speed this up in the interest of time for the video. Wow, it appears the neural activity has returned. Why was there a lag? You should discuss this with your students. You can see 2 minutes later, the spontaneous activity has returned, and we have a quite healthy response to manipulation. Now you can play these cool-down warm-up cycle games over and over again. Here's a sped-up video of me bringing the cockroach leg back into the garage. And again, around 20 degrees, it disappears. Now what if I heat the cockroach leg above room temperature? Is there a temperature at which the neurons will stop firing? I have lit a candle and placed it to the side. But I will first check to see if I get a nice evoked discharge at room temperature. And indeed I do. Now, I will move the flame directly underneath the cockroach leg to slowly heat it and see the effect of rising temperature on neural activity. Wow, I immediately see an increase in firing rate. And at 120 degrees, the neurons discharge all their ions and affect dying. And at 160 degrees, the tissue gives its last breath of electricity. I don't think the activity will come back. Let's test it. Back to room temperature, and no response. You can use this temperature control experiment in both the cold and warming directions to explain ion channel kinetics to your students. We look forward to hearing your ideas.